What are your goals for the future of the club, and how will you ensure that those goals will be reached?
I'd say the overall goal, at least in my mind for DSA personally, is that we're memorable. And I see that every year is different, and people remember, oh, last year I remember we did this, or before that we had a very fun time at this event. And my goal is to make an impact, very vague, but I want it to be something that people will remember us for who we did and what we did that time. And making sure that goal is attained is making sure that I'm accountable for all my cab members and making sure everyone's on task with that and being able to keep motivated, keep it lighthearted, but also keep it fun at the same time.
What is your leadership philosophy?
My personal opinion about that is my leadership philosophy is I like to keep it serious but also lighthearted at times. There's a lot of scenarios where we do have to be serious, and that could be whether the topic is very serious, and that could be either dealing with financial issues or things of that matter. And it's common sense to me that whenever something important is happening, that we should have that in mind, in their vision of mind. And whenever we feel like the task is not as important, I like to keep it as controlled, but lighthearted at the same time.
What experiences or events on CAB have prepared you to be a strong candidate for president? What experiences or events on CAB have prepared you to be a strong candidate for president?
My initial thought going into my webmaster position was, let me tell everyone, it was not what I expected at all. I literally just thought I would be maintaining the website, maintaining the Instagram, and that was almost as it was. And I did agree to helping out CAB wherever worse needed. And it kind of came to me in a second sense that there was more to do, and I voluntarily did that. For one of the examples is we started Epic not too long ago, and going out to Biffney and seeing learning all these new cultures and just learning more about Asian American heritage and everything was really nice. And also I was also tasked with helping out Bell fall of 2018. Where we went out to student diversity committee meetings, and when she wasn't there, I did fill in for her. And it was a little eye-opening as well, very uncomfortable for me at first, but because of that exposure, it gave me more experience and what I think would lead me to a really strong candidate today. And all that leading up to now is, at first, my initial response, I did not expect to be standing where I am right now. But overall, thinking about it as a whole, I think I'm ready for this position.
Do you have any new ideas for what could improve the club?
I think new ideas for improving the club. I want it to be more kind of, not a system, if that makes sense to everyone. I like it to be more kind of tight-knit, and that could be either planning more socials or probably just being able to connect between board members and GB members. I wouldn't want it to be the GB members would come out and they just kind of sit down, listen up, and then they kind of just leave. I would like them to get involved. And by doing that, I'd like to lead or probably just do more socials or just aspects that people would like to come to GVM for, or they would know VSA for what it was. So I probably introduce some things that we've probably never done at all or people have seen this past year. I'd like to do that.
And we will now open the floor for questions.
else too.
How active are you in the Vietnamese community in San Diego in general, and how are you going to implement that with VSA?
If people don't know, I'm actually part of a youth group from, it's called Chua Phat Da, it's a temple around Al Cajon. And originally I was just promoted to Huynh Chung, which is kind of like a leader in that youth group. And being a part of the Vietnamese American community, I'm also involved with the Nur Mesa Thai Festival every now and then. I also talk to one of the co-coordinators there, her name is Vina. She also does kind of help me out and try to work some things out with how we can keep the Vietnamese community alive here in San Diego. And we do that mainly between Vi and everything like that. So I'd say I've seen a pretty good connection with them in terms of that aspect. But I'd like to keep the Vietnamese heritage as long as they can, because that is what the Vietnamese Student Association is, and that's what we stand for.
Just gave him a thumbs up.
Are there any other questions from the floor?
What aspects of your own personal goals coincide with the goals of the organization, of VSA's organization?
You said it one more time.
What aspects of your personal goals coincide with the goals of the organization, of VSA?
I'd say probably my personal aspect goals is every now and then I kind of just go from point A to point B, but every now and then also some other times I like to go from point A to point B, but whatever trail I can take. What I mean by that is I know that within the club that we preserve and we kind of protect the Vietnamese culture as much as we can, and in my everyday life I don't have chance to do that, you know, being with a packed and a tight schedule like that. But I always, every now and then, I always just kind of sit down with my family, and every now and then, my family would talk to me about how it was in Vietnam. And I like for that to be a little bit more apparent in VSA, even though we do stand by it, but I feel like it could be a little bit more apparent in the club.
What is
VSA's
mission statement?
In the gist, VSA's mission statement is to preserve, protect, and to educate people about the Vietnamese culture.
So this is a scenario question. A CAB member hasn't attended CAB meetings or GBMs in 3 weeks and has not been notifying you at all. What do you do?
My first reaction will probably be to take myself out and try to help them out and ask them what has been the problem, because in this position you are a board member and everyone kind of expects you to be on your task and everything. In my scenario, I probably, if it gets to that extremity, I like to message them, ask them, is there a reason that you haven't been coming to GBMs or meetings in general? Is there something I can help out with? And wherever this scenario leads to, I would help them out on that part.
VSA and many other clubs in general have high attendance rates in the beginning of the fall semester and tends to die down throughout the year. What can you do to retain GBM or attendance numbers and promote VSA at SDSU?
It is true that it is very apparent, and that comes up with what I believe that it all starts with the board members. And if the board members aren't motivated to be there, willing to put in their time and their energy and effort to make the club fun what it is, then that's the result we'll be getting. If we're not motivated, then people would see like, oh, I'd rather be doing something personal, something that's worth more of my time than coming out to a club that doesn't put their all in there.
Do you you have any new ideas for what could improve the club?
Just kidding, sorry. Are there any other questions from the board?
What does BSA mean to you?
What BSA stands for me, especially this year, it's something that means a lot to me. I remember going into BSA just because it's Vietnamese and I'm Vietnamese. That's kind of like the what I was relating to. But what BSA meant to me was it's a family that I never expected to come with. And I'm very grateful for the people that I've met and connections that.
Thank you.